I greet you in the name of our dear Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you again for joining us this week again. I hope you had a wonderful week. I hope the Holy Spirit has been moving, training, teaching, leading you closer to Him through prayer. I hope your prayer life is also changing and you're enjoying the prayer life. One thing that I really want to tell you as a tip, when I was just getting ready, the Spirit of God told me this. And this is one of the things that have helped me also to prevail in the journey of prayer and to do it without regret, but having peace and joy. I know to some of you, when you hear about prayer, you think it is like a burden, a punishment. That's why when you tell people fasting and praying, people will be like, what? Because you think it's a punishment. But I want you to remember this, that prayer is a communication, a talk, a relationship with your Father in heaven. So enjoy it. I hope you're enjoying it. Before we go to today's session, let us pray. Holy Spirit, we thank you so much. Thank you for another week that you have given us to enter into your holy presence in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you for giving us the grace, the chance to be in your presence, to learn, to sit under your feet, to learn from you, Jesus, because you said we should learn from you. And here we are to learn from you through your wonderful Holy Spirit. Speak to us. Train us. Tell us what we should do in our journeys of prayer. And Lord, let every word that you teach us help us by the power of your Holy Spirit to live according to your word, to fulfill it, to do it your way. Help us, Holy Spirit, to ascend in the dimensions of prayer and intercession. And at the end of the day, all the glory and the honor, let them go back to you through whatever you will do, be it healings, be it miracles, be it transformation, be it love that you're going to pour into our hearts. Anything that you're going to do, Lord, take the glory in Jesus' name. Amen. So I wanted to share with you this testimony that I also was reminded to share with you before, as we are going on. I remember the first 3 years of my journey when the Spirit of God called me into full-time intercession and prayer. I remember the first 3 years, 2 years, the third year was not complete, first two years. The Spirit of God led me to pray for a few things. So that's how the journey started. He led me to pray for few things. And there were things that he told me, you need them in your journey. I'll teach by the grace of God in the following sessions, as the Spirit of God will give us the grace. These are the things that were personal. They are things that the Spirit of God told me, you really need them. You cannot ascend into higher dimensions of intercession without them. So he told me, first, pray. He led me to pray for humility. He led me to pray for love. He led me to pray for spirit of excellency. He told me to pray for that too. He told me to pray against the lust for money. Those are some of them. And he led me to pray for the intimate walk with the Holy Spirit. He led me to pray for holiness. So I went into prayer. There are some of them, others I'll share with you. For 2 years, praying for those things. And as I was praying, some of them, because when you pray for humility, of course, God will humble you. Of course, he will take you through a process that will humble you. When I prayed for love, he tested me. If I could love the unlovable. He was telling me to pray for the last against the last of money because he knew in the future, if I want to be blessed, then I must die to the last of money. He told me to pray for humility because he knew when he starts using me in miracles, signs, healings, wonders, and whatever he's doing, if I am not humble, pride will rise up and I'll take God's glory. Praise God. So I went into that journey. What the Spirit of God was doing for the first 2 years, he was dealing with me. And that's what prayer will do to you first. When you embark into a journey of prayer, if you want to see acceleration into a journey of prayer, if you want to see yourself growing from one dimension to another, and you want to remain, your graph to be climbing, your graph to be going up, if you don't want to end on the way through anything, then you should understand that the moment you start embarking into this journey, the Spirit of God will start pruning you, will start working with you. He will start dealing with some characters in you. And some surprisingly to some people will tell you, I am praying. But all that they are praying is just their shopping list. It's like they're pointing fingers around everything around them, but they forget themselves. They forget that they are the vessels that the Spirit of God will walk with. We forget that we are the people that are going to interact with the Holy Spirit. And we forget that the Holy Spirit, for him to interact with us, there are characters, there are attitude, there is a way, there is an atmosphere that allows him to stay and abide in us. So we focus on praying. I pray, like if you are a wife, I pray for my drunkard husband. I pray for my abusive husband. I pray for my wife. I pray for my stubborn wife. I pray for my wife who is talking too much. I pray for my children. I pray for that stingy grandmother. Or I pray for my mother-in-law who is not good to me. I pray for my friends who hates me. I pray for my co-workers and so forth. But we forget to scan ourselves. Make sure all the time you get time to present yourself before the Lord, to allow his scanning to be done in you, to check you whether you're okay or not. I've seen many times we might be thinking that it's that person. They hate me because of this and this. But you forget to check that they might be doing so because of you. There is something in you that is not okay. Now, the work of the Holy Spirit is he will deal with you personally, because he cannot walk with you unless you are in alignment with him. He cannot take you into an adventure. I call it an adventure. It's a wonderful journey. Intercession is a wonderful journey. Praying is a wonderful journey because you get time to spend with your Father in heaven. It's a privilege. Don't you see it? It's a wonderful time. It's a grace to be called in the presence of God, to stay there, no matter how long he wants, but him to come down and share with you his secrets, share with you his desires, the desires of his heart, and whatever he wants. It's a grace. It's a privilege. I call it an adventure. That's why I enjoy intercession. So if you want to walk with him, then there must be an alignment between you and him. So what he does first, when you start embarking into a journey, he will start dealing with you. Even when you meditate the word of God, because the word of God is the light. Now, because the word of God is the light, when you meditate and read it, the word of God will be speaking to you, telling you, there is this in you, deal with it. There is this pride in you, deal with it. There is this enviousness in you, deal with it. He They will tell you there is laziness in you because you cannot embark into a journey of intercession if you're lazy. There is this hatred in you. There is unforgiveness in you. Deal with it. He will be showing you. And your work in not to say, this is not my word. I think this word is meant for someone, because that's how the enemy does. Whenever you see a word that corrects us, we will think about another person. We forget that it's the Spirit of God at that time is speaking to you. Don't use read the Word of God, meditate it, and start looking for other people. No, the Spirit of God at that time is communicating with you. So whenever he will show me that this is the problem, this is something that you need to work on, then I will just write them down and start interceding. Mold me, Holy Spirit. Mold me the way you want. Shape me. He says he is a weaver. Weave me. Knit me. In Psalms, he said, you knitted me in my mother's womb. So that means he is a weaver. He is also a potter. Mold me the way you want. Make me in a way that you will be free to use me the way you want. Just deal with everything in me. Praise Jesus. So he will start working on you. That journey is not a journey that will be smooth. Because always, when the Lord is dealing with you personally, normally it's not easy, but it's worth it. After that, there is a breakthrough that you will experience, which is not beyond human comprehension. So when you embark into a journey of prayer, the Spirit of God will start breaking you. Some of us, there are things that we are going through because God is breaking us. You say, when I started praying, then things got worse. The Lord might be pruning you, might be dealing with you in some areas of your life, might be dealing with the things that he doesn't want them in your journey together, in the adventure that he's going to take you, in whatever he wants to do through you. He does not want you. So what is he doing? He's dealing with them in you. Is working on them. And that's why he's taking you there. So don't change the prayer points, because some of us, all that we pray is, I want a car, I want a house. I pray for a house, I pray for a car, I pray for children, I pray for promotion, I pray for the healing, I pray for this, that's all. Remember, any miracle, okay, it takes a prayer to receive a miracle. But it takes a character to maintain a miracle. So you see, you want that miracle, that blessing, that breakthrough which you had. You want it to stay with you? Do you want it to be permanent? I have seen people receiving miracles and later they don't have them. You hear them again 3 years later, 4 years later when they have lost, because it takes prayer to receive a miracle. You pray in the name of Jesus, you receive it. But to maintain it, it takes a character. It's you. It takes an attitude that pleases God to maintain a miracle, a blessing, an answer to the prayer that you have been praying. So if it takes a character, then don't you see that it's very important for you to work on your character at a place of prayer? I advise you, take time to pray for yourself. Scan yourself today. As we meet next week, I hope you will have worked on yourself. Take those 7 days of fasting and pray. And even if 7 days they are not done, don't rush. Just allow him. I told you, he dealt with me for 2 good years. Now, take time, write them down one after the other. Sit down at your place of prayer where you kneel down. Sit down there. Tell the Holy Spirit, here I am. Open-minded, with open heart. I'm ready. Tell me. Then write them one after the other. If he tells you you are a thief, deal with it. If he tells you you are unfaithful, deal with it. If he tells you you are proud, deal with it. If he tells you you have a lot, you have unforgiveness, an unforgiving heart, deal with it. If he tells you you're lazy, deal with it. Write them down, all of them. Then start praying for one after the other. So prayers molds you. Prayers shapes you. Prayers nurtures you to be a mighty giant woman and man of God. Most of the missions you see, most of the great movements you see, great men and women of God, they were birthed, they were nurtured at a place of prayer. Prayer brings out the best out of you. I said the first day, the first week we were starting, that if you have never been to a place of prayer, then you don't know who you are. The moment you start praying, a best person who is hidden inside you will come out of you and will start manifesting. And you yourself, not only people around you, you yourself, you'll be amazed with the person that you have become. James chapter 4 verse 8, the Bible says, draw near to God and he will draw near to you. When you embark into a journey of prayer, you are drawing near unto God. And remember, the Lord is light. The more you draw near, he will scan you. The light will show you what is not okay in you, what is not right in you. And he is also the consuming fire. His fire will consume unnecessary characters, unnecessary behaviors. You see, this is a big problem with most of the intercessors. We pray, but we have a lot of characters to deal with them. Sit down to pray, but at the same time that you pray, you use prayer gathering for gossip. You sit down to pray, but at the same time, okay, this is an example of the Spirit of God. At the same time, you have hatred in you. You have not forgiven. In my early years, when by the grace of God, I'm still very baby, yeah, being mentored with my spiritual father, Prophet Sadhu, I'm still a very baby. So in the early years, I remember, there are times that you don't align. There are times that you quarrel, not quarreling to the, I don't know, but that one can be now called abuse if it's punching, using knives, using whatever. No, that is abuse and so forth. But I remember misunderstanding will happen in my marriage between me and my husband. And I have an appointment daily, at night, 3 a.m., my appointment with the Holy Spirit. I must rise up. I don't kneel down there. No, my appointment, I meet him in my prayer room at my house. So I have to walk up. Many times, it was happening many times. When I declare that, okay, this is another thing. When I declare that I'm going to fast and so forth, or when I'm praying and so forth, maybe just normal misunderstanding happened and so forth. I get angry. I go. I want to sleep. I turn, you know, sleeping on the bed. You turn on the other side. Or you're sleeping, but you're not talking. You know, if you're married, you understand it. So now 3 a.m. is ready. I have to go to the prayer room to pray. I wake up. I remember this day I'm going there. And he told me, you cannot pray with that such heart. Go and ask for forgiveness. Go and ask for forgiveness. Ah. So I told the Holy Spirit, don't you know that he's the one who wronged me? Didn't you see him how he did? Don't you know that it's his mistake? Then it is him who should ask me for forgiveness. Why are you sending me to say sorry when it's him who did hurt me? The Holy Spirit asked, what do you want, me or the pain in you? So I went to my room, you know, that it's painful, it's here, and there's that ego and pride, and you're like, because for you even to count yourself righteous is because you have ego, you have pride. So I went to my room, and I remember I went there, and then I had to wake him up, hit him. I'm sorry, my husband, I'm sorry. He's like, sorry for what? I'm sorry. I was like, I'm sorry, because I allowed quarrel to come between us and so forth. Inside, I'm feeling painful, you know, that pride inside. The pride was so much, I had to say sorry. So I said sorry. And when I said sorry, I went back to pray. He dealt with me that way for some time. And then later I understood. Forgiveness is not only because they deserve, someone deserves to be forgiven, but because you want to draw near to your Father through prayer. You want to get closer to Him and you want Him to come close to you. Then you have no other option than forgiving. It doesn't matter who is wrong, but you just have to forgive. So the Spirit of God was dealing with me through that. The Bible says, the Lord is near to all who call on Him, to all who call on Him in truth. In truth, when it comes to prayer, we have to pray with truth. You don't pray pretending, expecting people to hear you, that you're a good prayerful person, good intercessor. You can pray a long time and so forth. It had to be in truth. And that's why the Spirit of God will take you through the pruning, that your prayer can be true. Your prayer can be genuine. Your prayer can be honest. This week, I want to challenge you. But I want to encourage you, go to a place of prayer. Write down, just tonight, get time, sit at a place of prayer. Write them down. What are the things that you think, these ones, will destroy my relationship with the Holy Spirit? What are the things that you think, indeed, these ones, they'll block me from growing into a journey of prayer? Check yourself. What are the things that you think these ones, they will not take me higher where I desire to go? I want you to check on yourself. I want you to know that you are doing the right thing when you allow the Holy Spirit to scan you. And when you finish, go and pray. Go and pray into a fasting until the Spirit of God says, it's over. Let's pray. Spirit of God, we thank you. We glorify you and honor you. We praise you, we give you glory, Hannah, and praises forever and ever. Thank you for this beautiful hour. Thank you for checking our hearts. May your light shine into our hearts, because prayer communication is done from a truthful heart, a genuine heart. Spirit of God, check us. If there is anything in us that does not please you, if there is anything that will block, will delay us from growing into the journey of intercession, is anything in us that is not pleasing before you, Holy Ghost, deal with us. Deal with us. Work on us. Reveal every hidden sin, every sin that entangles us easily, every character, every weakness in us, that we are embracing them, hiding them, holding them closer, thinking that we are righteous, counting ourselves righteous than others. Holy Spirit, reveal everything. Reveal that pride. Reveal that lust for money. Reveal that sin. Reveal the fornication. Reveal the addiction. Reveal that unfaithful in marriage, unfaithful when it comes to finances. Reveal it in us, Holy Spirit. Reveal that laziness. Reveal it, Holy Spirit. Every bad thought in our minds, when we think evil concerning people, reveal them, Holy Ghost, and let your fire consume them. We come to you with repentant hearts. Forgive us, Father. Forgive us, Holy Ghost. We want to start afresh with you. We want to go with you far. We don't want to end on the way. We want you to take us wherever you want to take us through this journey and in this journey of prayer. Thank you, Holy Spirit, because you will not stop dealing with your children. You will keep on dealing with them. You will keep on working on them, molding them, shaping them, nurturing them, changing them until they become the vessels that you want them to become. In Jesus' mighty name, we prayed. Amen. Thank you so much for joining us. We love you and God bless you. Amen.